IRA here, 401k there, an account here, an account there. No one has really put this all together for you. We can actually hand you a plan. The biggest thing you deserve is that plan. You're going to be okay even if you live beyond 800. Most of the people that come to see us, their main concern is, when can I retire? Is my money going to last? How does this whole thing going to look like now that I'm here at this stage of my life?
When a client walks in the door, we don't want them to feel rushed. Their time is important to us. We want them to be comfortable as they're sitting here waiting.
Experience is something that we can be taught, but love, care, and personality is something that really has to be in your nature. So we're very fortunate that we've surrounded ourselves with that type of characters around us in this office.
We ensure that our clients hear from us on a regular basis.
A big part of what we do is to help them. Where do you think you can put your money and how everything will be affected? What we really, really work hard at is to show them what is it that their financial future can look like. Now you have to really ask those questions that maybe you haven't even thought about.
Anyone that comes in is treated like family, and it is an ongoing relationship that continues year after year.
I've passed away four down a year. David and the staff here have not only come just to support me and my cause, but they've jumped in and supported the organization as well. There's a natural caring and honesty that comes from David. There's nothing manufactured, it's just in his heart.
David has a really, he's a very honorable person. Every aspect of his life, he really strives to help other people.
Family to me is everything. I thank my lucky stars every day for having my wife Carrie. You could win the lottery tomorrow, you could have millions. But if you don't have a happy home to come to, to me, none of this is worth it.
Your life is not stagnant. Your life is changing, your life is evolving. County Advisory Group wants to meet with you on a regular basis to see what those changes are.
I love spending time with people, I love meeting people. And what I really, really learned about retirement was from the people that we help. The true happiness comes from, you know, the lives that we touch.
We want our families to take a look at the horizon where they're going. And we're going to be the captains and we'll steer the ship in that direction.
This person is your advocate for your dreams in the future, so you need to be able to trust them.
It should be the time that you enjoy everything that you've built and worked hard for.
Retirement should be about doing the things you want to do. And frankly, I love doing what I do so much that I've seen myself doing this forever.
خب دوستان عزیز سلام عرض میکنم خیلی خوش اومدین من داستان منو فرزانه‌جون داره تعریف کردن یه دارم من براتون تعریف میکنم ایشون گفتم که من 29 ساله که تو این کار هستم ولی داستانش اینه که این جولای میشه 9 ساله که من در کالیفرنیا هستم و اونجا در دبیرستان با خانم آشنا شدم بعد که انقلاب شد با ماینا آمدم دیگه اونجا بودیم و 33 سال ما کنتاکی بودیم و در سال 2006 دیگه از گرما و شرجی بودن و سرما و یخ و بارون خسته شدیم اومدیم اینجا حالا البته اینجا میگن حالا آخر چند نفر از رادیو راستی تشریف بردیم خب الحمدلله که مسیج من رو فهمیدیم به فارسی که اومدیم میشم چون فارسی من همچین یه ذره قرابتی خواهد بود میتونم دوستانه باید صحبت بکنم ولی با اجازتتون امشب برنامه من به انگلیسی میگم ولی جواب سوالتون رو سعی میکنم به فارسی بدم و بعدم اینجا خواهم بود که هر جواب و اگه چند سوالی داشتیم من به فارسی یا هر جوری شده با هم صحبت میکنم که قشنگ شما جوابتون رو بگیم خب آماده این ما از این به بعد موظفیم که هر جلسه که می‌داریم، هر کلاس سمیناری که می‌داریم از دوستان خواهش میکنیم که این برنامه ها رو فوروارد کنین و دریافت کنین. قولی که من به شما میدم، من اینجا هستم که به شما کمک بکنم. نه وقتش هست و نه ریسورس دارید که ما خدای نکرده به شما زنگ بزنیم، اگر نخواهید اذیتت میکنیم بذاریم توی میلینگ لیست، ایمیل لیست. نه وقتش هست نه سرمایه‌اش. برای همین ما تنها کسایی میخواهیم کمک کنیم که اگر شما اینجا گفتید یس، بعد از اینکه حرف من تموم شد باهاتون قرار میذاریم، میشینیم برای اون فری کانسالتیشنی که من بهتون قول میدم، هر جوری هر کمکی از اصلا بر بیاد براتون میکنم. فقط سخت ترین کاری که شما باید امشب باید بکنید به غیر از خوردن شام اینه که باید این بالای اینو پر بکنید. خواهش میکنم شماره میزتون هم بذارید که اگر ما سوالی چیزی داشتیم بدونید شما کجا نشستید. وقتی که من دارم صحبت میکنم، اگر پوینتی که به مربوط به این باکس ها بود میتونیم مارک بکنیم که یادتون باشه که بعدا راجبش اگه سوال دارین یا بخواییم ما هم صحبت کنیم. هیچ یادداشتی رو این کاغذ نکنید، برای اینکه چه هر یادداشتی بکنید چه خوب چه بد من قرار اینه بگیرم. برای همین یه صفحه اونجا هست، یه صفحه خالی برای نوتس توی فولدرتون هست، اینجا لطفا یادداشت بکنید. اینجا یادداشت نکنید که ما آخر جلسه اینو از همه پیک آف میکنیم. شما نانو نانو نداریم جان؟
نانو
در بار نانو در بار؟ خیلی ساده است، چی کار نکنید؟ خیلی ساده. خب آماده این؟ شروع کنیم؟ بهتون گفتن که این جلسه نیست که 3 ساعت طول میکشه، درسته؟
5 ساعت
ببینید، از موقعی که من شروع کردم تا موقعی که خداحافظی کنم 1 ساعت معمولا طول میکشه. حالا با این فارسی، انگلیسی و پینگلیش و انگلیش و اینا ممکنه این 5 دقیقه در حد طولانی تر شه. اینا آماده هستن میدونن که شما به محضی که کار من تموم شد میان ظرفا رو برمیدارن و شامو میارن. Very good?
Okay.
خب، این دیسکلیمر منه. دیسکلیمر من میگه که ببینید چیزایی که من دارم صحبت میکنم راجبش به هیچ مو به هیچ عنوانی is not a recommendation because I don't know anybody in this room, I don't know the situation. Point هایی که we're going to talk about is really take it as an idea. Then if you have a chance when we can sit down together, then we can talk about it to see if any of these ideas will apply to you. We're going to talk about tax and legal issues. Any CPAs in the room? Okay. So I'm not a CPA, I'm not an attorney. Please consult with a CPA or an attorney for any issue that is related to tax or legal matter. At the end of the program, we're going to offer you an hour of my time for a free consultation or a second opinion. And at the end, we're not related to any U.S. government agency. I might be talking about Social Security or anything related to that, but I'm not affiliated with the U.S. government. Did I do a good job on disclaimer?
Jump on, sir.
Okay. We deal mostly with people who are concerned about retirement. The people who we help are generally 50 and older. Hold on. If you're 45 years old and you're concerned about retirement and you want to be safe with your money, I might be able to help. We are generally advisors helping you with your safer money strategies. We help in ideas and areas that your principal is going to be as safe as much as we can. That's the main message of basically what I do tonight. So, when a family comes to see me, usually they've worked hard, they've built their retirement nest egg, they've sacrificed, they've taken chances, they've risked. But it's always a mess, right? You have an IRA, 401k, like I said in the video, a mutual fund account here. This is what it looks like. So our goal is, when we're done, when we put a plan together, everything comes together perfectly like an organized puzzle. Because most of the time, it's not about what I have, it's about what is the plan? How is this thing going to look like when I want to retire? Is my money going to last? Is it going to be there for the next 30, 40 years after retirement? Because we're living longer and longer. So
that's our goal with any family that comes to see us. We generally have a three-step review process. This first starts with an income tax review. One of the main things we look at is your tax return, your 1040. Let me ask a question. We just finished the tax season, April 15th, right? So whatever happens in December 31st, the time is finished. Then January, February, we get our W-2s, 1099s. We collect all of that. Hopefully, by the time we need to do this, we give it to a professional who's going to prepare the tax, right? So hopefully you get a phone call, Mr. and Mrs. Smith, the boss is Smith. please come, your tax return is ready. You go and sign the tax return, you see how much damage you've done, and say, oh my God, I got how much I have to pay. You sign it, you mail it, and we're done, right? When is the next time we're going to look at that tax return?
Next year.
Next year, right? So, that's the problem. Today, now is the time we need to plan on tax reduction strategies. When tax season comes, it's too late. Your tax advisor or your tax preparer, their job is to help you figure out how much are the taxes. They don't have much time during the busiest time of the year to give you tax reduction ideas. By the way, does anyone get a call from a tax advisor to say, Mr. and Mrs. Smith, please come in, we noticed that you paid a lot of taxes last year. Come on in, we're going to help you with some tax reduction strategies. Anybody gets that phone call? Usually you don't. They're busy. If you're lucky, they're going to put the numbers in the right places, they're doing the job correctly, and they're going to have you sign it and send it off. For this reason, we need to have a proactive look at your tax return. Your tax return, to me, is like an x-ray to a physician. Where are the problem areas? Are you paying phantom taxes? Meaning, paying tax on money you lost, which is a whole different story. So, that's the first one. The second one is income planning. What do? When it comes time to retirement, how is this going to look like? Is my money going to last? Or, what about timing? I'm in risky investments. I'm doing really good. By the way, the market is up right now, right? Generally up. And everybody's happy. It's like the tide that raises all the boats. And then, an example. 2007, Ayyatul Moshe was a great year in the market. The market did really good. So pretend all these retirement parties are going on. We're celebrating, getting ready to retire, I can't wait. You look at your accounts, you see, okay, by the time I take my income, which is a nice income, my accounts are still gonna grow because the market is up, right? So you retire. What happened after 2007? 2008 came, the recession came. The average portfolio lost how much? 30-40% at least. So, oh my God, I'm retired. I just lost 30-40% of my portfolio, but I gotta get that income out. So statistically, if you take money, the same amount of money, from a portfolio that just went down 30-40%, what can happen? You can run out of money. So we have to be on some safer strategies. In our firm, because we specialize in retirement planning, we have a belief that a good portion of your income should come from safe sources. Your retirement income should not be dependent on what happened to Greece, what happened in China, who's going to be our next president, what happened to the price of oil. The check should keep coming, just like a pension, just like Social Security. Lastly, risk exposure. Every time the market goes up and down, if you get some funny feeling inside your tummy, perhaps you're taking more risk than you should. So maybe you have to back off, look at more safer strategies. And by the way, when I say safe strategies, that's not money putting money in the bank. Because yes, money in the bank is safe, but are you making any money? No, you're going backwards. So by the time you figure inflation, you're losing your buying power. So that's why we want to make sure when you're approaching the retirement years, we have some safer strategies in place. Okay? So that's our three-step review process. Tax reduction strategies. This is very simple.
Yeah, but I'm here.
Cool. Tax reduction strategies. It's very simple. Very simple. Here's what happened. I call this kind of my three barrel or three bucket strategies. What happens is most of you, most clients, most people who have income or investments, whether you need the income or not, it all shows up on your tax return. So once that happens, we've lost control because now perhaps you're paying tax on money you're not using. So for that reason, we want to reduce those taxable dollars as much as we can. So what I do is I've divided it into a now bucket, a later bucket, and a never bucket, which I'll explain in a minute. So let's talk about the now bucket. This is the bucket that you need money from right now. You need to buy a car. You need to go on vacation. Perhaps you want to help the kids and the grandkids, right? That's where the money should be. Yes, I'm paying taxes, but that's okay. I'm using it, right? When you use it, we can't help it. You gotta pay the tax. So we only wanna put just enough money there for what we're using. We don't wanna put any more there because we're paying tax on money we're not using. For that reason, for anything else, we're gonna push it to this later bucket. What goes in the later bucket? That's where we wanna have our tax efficient accounts, IRAs, Roths, tax-free bonds, annuities, life insurance, things that are not going to be taxed, or at least they're going to be taxed later, tax deferred. You see this little shit-all? The purpose of that is, whenever we run out of money here, we just transfer money into this as we need it. But the bulk of this money grows tax deferred for as long as we want, or perhaps if it's an IRA, we have to follow IRA rules. At age 70 and a half, we have to start taking a minimum amount. By the way, some argue that what's the benefit of tax deferred? Because when I want to take the money out, I still got to pay the tax anyways, and then I have to pay tax on a larger sum of money. Let me prove that theory wrong. So I'm gonna have a game. If we have $1, اگه یه دلار داشته باشیم و 20 دفعه این دلار رو دو برابر کنیم. یعنی یه دلار میشه دو، دو دلار میشه چهار، چهار میشه هشت. کی میتونه حدس بزنه بعد از 20 دفعه چقدر پول خواهیم داشت؟ چرا؟ نه، حالا شما حدس بزنید. حساب رو
میلیون.
چقدر؟ یه میلیون؟
بیش از این.
بیش از این. شما با چقدر؟
ده میلیون دو.
ده میلیون بار بابا یه دلار میشه. شما مثل مهندسی.
نه.
ها؟ ببینید، من این سوال رو دو شب یا چهار شب هر ماه برای دوستان امریکایی میکنم. همه یه دیگه عددی میگنم را. من ماه پیش برای اول ما بعد دوستان ایرانی داشتم به تعریف میکرد یه دونه جواب درست حسابه من نهده هر فرمول دارم من گفتم بابا جون یه حدسی بزنه ایشون درست گفتن یه دلار تقریبا میشه یک میلیون دلار یه ذره بیشتر حالا بیایم مجسم کنیم که ما توی یه تکس برکت 25% هستیم و حالا هر دفعه که اون دلار رو دو برابرش کنیم 25% رو کم می کنید.
همین شما $10 گذاشته بودم.
هر دفعه دلار دو برابرش میکنیم 25% کم میکنیم چون مثلا میخوایم تکسش رو بدیم. حالا حد بزنیم چقدر خواهیم داشت بعد از 20 دفعه؟
250 تا.
شما؟ هر دفعه که دو برابر میکنیم این دفعه فقط 25% کم میکنیم به خاطر تکس. 750 250 شما درست گفتید. بعد از این بگید
یه چیزی بگم.
500,000
یه چیزی
دیگه سرش
نکنید.
نه بگید. حالا ببینید ساده فقط میخوام تکس دیفر با تکس بالا حساب کنید. دوستان میشه 74,000 خونده دلار. یه میلیون کجا؟ 74,000 دلار کجا؟ حالا شما که بحث میکنید که ببینید من بهتون گفتم حالا باید یک عالمه تکس بدم، درسته؟ بیشترین تکسی که روی 1,000,000 دلار باید بدین چقدره؟ 50% بشین، حالا بگید 50% میشه 500,000 دلار. حالا 500,000 دلار بهتره یا 74,000 دلار؟ چون شما میخواستین هر سال تکستون رو بدین. برای همین توجه کنید tax deferred works. So we have a saying, if you're not going to use it, why pay the tax? Delay it, defer it as much as you can. پس میشه این باکت. حالا باکت never چیه؟ For those of you that maybe most people here are pretty young, when you reach an age که میگین که بابا من که دیگه پولو نمیتونم با خودم ببرم، این حالا پول بعد برسه بچه ها و نما و اینا، حالا چی کار کنم؟ چون شاید بعد یک عالمه مالیات بدم، شاید بره تو پروبیت، پرابلم های خیلی زیادی خواهد بود. How can I pass this efficiently to the next generation? That goes in the never bucket. That's part of the planning that we do to help you pass that money with the minimum amount of tax in the most efficient way. So, as an advisor, we are not an accumulation advisor. We are not a growth advisor. Yes, we want your money to grow. Yes, we want to beat inflation. We specialize on preservation and distribution. So, if someone comes to my office and says, last year I made 10%. من میخوام ببینم شما میتونید امسال برای من مثلا 15% روش کنید پول منو. That will be a very short meeting. با هم چایی بخوریم، ولی I am not the right advisor for you. اونا معمولا کارهای استاک بروکر و کسایی که ریسک دوست دارن. پس این It's a very important message about how to plan for your taxes. We want to delay taxes as much as we can. Four phases of money. As you are getting older, as you're getting closer to retirement, from the time you start working and have income, first phase is your accumulation phase. Remember I said the accumulation. You're looking for savings, growing. If the market did take a dive, it's okay. We have time. We're dollar cost averaging. We have 401ks. We're just putting money away. Eventually it's going to come back. Then as we get closer to retirement, we reach our preservation years. Now I gotta be careful. Now I gotta start protecting my money. Maybe I wanna take risk with a little bit of it, but most of it I want to protect. Because when 2008 happened, when you lost 40% of your portfolio, it wasn't until 2013 when you just got even. So what if you're getting ready to retire and another 2008 happens? Do we have enough time to recover? Income planning stage. Now I'm retired. Now I need to get income from my portfolio. How is that going to look like? Do I have a plan? And finally, this is the age was I was talking about, distribution. How can I pass this to my children, grandchildren, in the best way I can? So we want to look at strategies that maximizes your income. Social Security by itself is a very complicated thing. By the way, یادم رفت بپرسم چند نفر شما قبلا توی فاینانشال ورکشاپ دینر بودین شرکت کردین؟ Very good. چند نفر توی ورکشاپ یا دینر سمینار چیز بودین؟ فقط راجع به سوشال سکیوریتی شما بودین؟ Very good. خب ببینید من یه کلاس برام میذارم، یه سمینار میذارم فقط برای سوشال سکیوریتی. حالا اون سمینار فقط برای کسایی خوبه که هنوز سوشال سکیوریتی شروع نکردن. وقتی شروع کرده باشیم دیگه it's too late. We can't optimize. ولی دولت امریکا بعد از سال 2000 به ما یه اپتیمایزیشن استراتژی هایی دادن که شما برای اولین بار میتونید وایسی سوشال سکیوریتیتون رو عقب بندازین. چرا عقب بخواییم بندازین؟ برای اینکه بعد از 66 سالگی برای بیشتر از شما 8% تا 70 سالگی 32% میتونه رشد کنه. چه اینوستمنتی شما میتونید پیدا کنید که 32% گارانتی میتونید بگیرید که رشد کنه؟ برای همین میمونه آپتیمایزد. ولی این استراتژی ها اجازه میده که همسرتون به جایی که شما به جایی که ایشون وایسن میتونن 50% بنفیت شما رو بگیرن without affecting the other spouse in any way, in a negative way. خیلی جالبه و میگم این فقط یک چیز با خودشه که اگر انشاءالله if we have a chance to sit together we can do this for you. Help maximize income. Make sure it's tax efficient. Taxes can eat your income alive. These are what I call cracks in your bucket. We want to cover as much of these taxes. We want to make sure that whatever planning we do, it lasts for the rest of our life. Do we know how long we're going to live? And what we're hearing, it's good news, bad news, that we're living longer and longer and longer, whether we like it or not. But I mean, we want to make sure it lasts for your lifetime. We want to make sure that we don't compromise. You want to stay in the same lifestyle that you have right now. You're not going to say, oh my God, I'm not sure what's going to happen. I don't have a plan, so I need to cut back. I can't drive that car that I wanted, or I need to downsize. I can't live here anymore. I got to go to a smaller place. But مهمتر از اینه که you've got to have a plan. Nothing happens without a plan. It's not supposed to be that you come and see me, oh, I have this great product. I have this great mutual fund or great annuity and it looks like you can invest in it. Let's go and invest. No, we gotta have a plan. Anything that we do goes following a plan, after a plan. So here's your nest egg. We have two sources. We want to provide cash through a guaranteed source or in a responsible way in what we call actively managed, where we're not going to just blindly put the money in a mutual fund. By actively managed, perhaps you might have limited upside, but perhaps we can protect some of your downside. And that's what we mean by actively managed. Cool. Let's have some fun and talk about the stock market. کی فکر میکنه که دیگه پرابلم‌ها تموم شده و مارکت قراره پش بره بالا؟ Anybody? خجالت نکشید. معمولا یکی دو تا حتما این مارکت پایین میره، دست بالا نمیره، بالا بره پس بعد دست بره بالا. خلاصه is the crisis over. ببینید هیچکی نمیدونه، هیچکی نمیدونه. هر کی من گفت میدونه لطفا run away as fast as you can because nobody knows. It's a very complicated world today. There's so many variables. So here's what Mr. Mark Twain said. شما میشناسی که Mark Twain درسته؟ ایشون گفتن که October is one of the particularly dangerous months to invest in stocks. شما نشنیده بودین؟
نه.
نشنیده بودین؟ Mark Twain میدونه دیگه اینو دیگه درسته؟
تازگی
گفته. تازگی گفته. چیزش هم پوزش دید شده. حالا آقای مارک توین از کجا ستاک مارکت بارده؟ ایشون نویسندن، درسته؟ حالا آقای مارک توین گفته اگه ببینیم آره دینجرز وانس آر جولای، جنوری، سپتامبر، نوامبر، مارچ. نمیدونه ولی واقعا دلیلی که من این سوال رو میذارم توی اینداستری ما گفته شده که اکتبر ماه بعدی است. چون مثلا 30 سال پیش بلک مانده که تو بازارات ۱۹۷ حالا اکتبر ماه بعدی هیچ چیزی نیست. هیچ حساب کتابی نداره. ما باید مواظب پولمون باشیم. فقط مهم اینه که what age are you? Where are you in your lifespan?
البته هر
7
سالی
اتفاق میفته. اکتبر
هر
7 سالی
اتفاق
میفته. ببینید شما این
چه میگه من نمیگه. تو سالش
بله. بعدا بیم با شما صحبت میکنم. حالا این مهمترین پوینته. This is the most important thing. When you are close to retirement, when you are at retirement, do you want to rely on the stock market for retirement income? برای اینکه the worst thing that can happen, are you familiar with an idea called dollar cost averaging? Everybody pretty much knows about dollar cost averaging. That means if you're contributing to a 401k, which is the best example of a dollar cost averaging, every 2 weeks, whenever you get paid, we're buying shares, right? We're buying shares. We're adding to our 401k. So if the market is down, I'm buying lower cost shares. So over a lifetime, over a lifespan, long term, eventually we're going to see a nice gain over our portfolio with dollar cost averaging. But there is a thing called reverse dollar cost averaging. That could be devastating to your accounts. That means if we have another 2008 and you retire, you're taking money, now we're taking money from the worst time possible. We're selling shares at the lowest price, and that's what could possibly cause you running out of money. So we want to make sure at least a good portion of our income does not rely on the stock market. Cool. Stock market, it can do three things. Go up, go down, or go sideways, right? ببینید دوستان 9 سال تو کشید که من یاد گرفتم. خب، حالا let's have some fun with this. Right now we're in a month of June. این شده داره جولای میشه. How many think that this year we're going to end with a up year in the stock market? We're going to have a good year in the stock market.
سال از همون سال است که تا اکتبر خیلی بیشتر یاد
وای
چون همون
2008 همون
2008
هم 7 ساله که سوال بعدی بودید. ولی آبا شما خجالت دیگه هیچ که بد نمیدونم مارکت دینه بالا. خب پس شما آدینس خوبی هستی برای من. حالا ایشون گفتن و کی فکر میکنه که we're gonna have a down year in the market؟ یکی دو تا چند نفر. من خودم فکر میکنم که مثل بقیه اگر بقیه رو هنوز نخوابیدین چون دستتون رو بلند نکردین اینه که مارکت قراره سایدویز باشه و الان بهتون میتونم نشون بدم که هیستوریکلی نگاه کنیم امکانش خیلی زیاده. دوباره آیا من میدونم؟ نه، ولی اقلا هیستوریکلی میتونیم یه اسامشنهایی داشته باشیم. برای همین حالا حرف من اینه، ما الان چند نفر گفتیم که مارکت قراره بره پایین، بعضی هم گفتن که بیشتر گفتن که مارکت قرار سایدویز بره. هیچ کی دستشو بالا نکرد که قرار بالا بره. ولی من شرط می‌بندم که با وجود اینکه دو سه تا دوستان کلاینت هستن توی اتاق ولی اکثرا نیستن، اونایی که من نمی‌شناسم و کلاینت نیستن، حاضرم شرط ببندم که یک مقدار، یک درصدی از شما، درصد زیادی از شما پولتون جایی هست که فقط در چه موقعی قراره خوب باشه؟
بره بالا.
خب ما الان گفتیم که قراره یا بره پایین یا بره سایدویز. پس why are we doing the same thing expecting different results? We have to try new things. We have to try different things. And این وظیفه منه که به شما نشون بدم که چه کارا میتونیم بکنیم. خب حالا یه ذره راجع به تاریخ مارکت رو بحث کنیم. در سال 1925 داو جونز بود 200، بعد 200، بعد رفت بالا به زمانی بود که بهش میگفتن Roaring Twenties و این موقعی بود که تکنولوژی، the biggest technology was radio، کمپانی بود به نام RCA و به خاطر این تکنولوژی رادیو کمپانی RCA مارکت خیلی رفت بالا. به اوج رسید 400 شد. 200 شد 400، دو برابر شد. بعد همه می‌دونیم چی شد. دیپرشن شد، the big crash و مارکت افت کرد، خیلی بد شد. 20 سال طول کشید. 20 سال طول کشید بالا پایین بالا پایین که تازه برسیم به اون جایی که تقریبا بودیم. پس حواستون باشه. بعدش شد 40s and 50s. این زمانی بود که جنگ جهانی دوم تموم شده بود. امریکا was doing fantastic. تمام manufacturing was big in US. Housing, automobile, baby boomers were being born. خیلی موقعی خوبی بود در امریکا. What did the market do? It went up. بعد شد 1960s and 70s. اگه یادتون باشه، حالا زیاد سیاسیش نکنیم، پرزیدنت کارتر فقط 4 سال تو این 18 سال پرزیدنت بود، ولی بهش میگن the Carter years. چرا؟ برای اینکه همه چی خرابکار شده بود. اینترست ریت خیلی بالا بود، بنزین زیاد بود و آنیمپلویمنت بد بود. مارکت هیچ کاری نکرد. داو جونز بود فکر میکنم 996 سال 64، 18 سال بعد تموم شد توی 1006 از 996 به فقط 1006. Very little movement. بعد شد 80s and 90s. اینو خیلی از شما دوستان بعد یادتون بیاد. استاک مارکت داشت خیلی خوب میشد و خوبم شد. به طوری که وقتی که به 90s رسید دیگه همه ما اکسپرت شده بودیم. همه شدیم استاک مارکت. بعد که رفتیم مهمونی صحبت استاک های مختلف بود. آیا شما سیسکو دارین؟ یادتون میاد سیسکو رو؟ کوالکام یادتون میاد؟ ای او ال؟ من 5000 دلار گذاشتم، حالا شده 250000 دلار. و واقعا هم درست بود. شما میتونستید قشنگ تایمش کنید. مثل که بود یه قدم عقب بزنید، فردا سه قدم جلو بود. و اینجوری خیلی ها شروع کردن، خودشون اینوست کردن. اینقدر طول کشید که همه آلوده شدیم. همه رفتیم توی تکنولوژی، برای که واقعا جوانایی بودن 20 ساله میرفتن برای این کمپانی ها کار میکردن، اوورنایت میلیونر میشدن. بعد چی شد؟ سال 2000 average portfolio چقدر در پایین؟ 50-60%. The people got devastated. Technology got really bad. Still today it hasn't come back. So those 18 years were great years. بعد الان ما رسیدیم به سال 2015. حالا if you look at the pattern، ببینید این ساینتیفیک زیاد نیست، ولی if you I'll show you another slide can back this up. میخواستم که تا جوری که میشه ساده بتونشون بدم. 20 سال سایدویز، 20 سال رفت بالا، 18 سال دوباره سایدویز، دوباره تقریبا 18 سال رفت بالا. حالا ما 2015 هستیم. آیا will history repeat itself؟
دقیقا، برای که اگه نگاه کنید الان 7 سال پیش و 14 سال پیش 9-11 بود، 14 سال پیش 9-11 اومد پایین، 14 سال پیش بعد از 7 سال دوباره رفت بالا، دوباره الان اومد پایین، الان آخر 7 ساله، الان دوباره کرش میکنه، از سال بعد دوباره شروع میکنه.
حالا من نمیدونم ایشون میدونه یا ایشون
میدونه، من میدونم نگاه کنید هر هفته میبینه
هم موضوع دیگه که دوستان عزیز We need to try different things. We cannot keep doing the same thing. Right now, we're all in this feeling of goodness. Market is up, everything's going to be great. Forget about the 2008. Very good. موازه باشین, you can take a hit. این هم اون سپورتی که اون گرافی که بزن گفتم. This was put out by Guggenheim Investment. Dow Jones Historical Trend. میبینید این طبقاتو. من از اینجا آبا خلاصه کردم. من از 1920 شروع کردم. تقریبا روی این گراف هم 25, 11, 17 این دو راه هست. Please, you have to be careful and aware of that. حالا, این هم خیلی جالبه. Volatility in the market. If you listen to the news, to the financial news, volatility is a big thing. نوسان. میگیم که خیلی الان زیاد شده. اگر هیستوری رو نگاه کنید میخوام ببینید که S&P برای 3% چقدر بالا پایین رفته. در از 1970 تا 1980 18 دفعه، از 80 تا 90 25 دفعه، از 90 تا 2000 27 دفعه، تقریبا یه ذره رشد کرده. یه دفعه ببینید از 2000 تا 2010 101 دفعه. Volatility خیلی زیاد شده. حالا if you are a trader and you like buying and selling, volatility is a good thing. ولی if you don't have the stomach for it, if you want to save, this is obvious. حالا ما چیکار میخوایم بکنیم؟ ما میخوایم یک شو کنیم که وقتی که شما به اون زمانی رسیدین که میخواین بازنشسته بشین، نگران درآمد بازنشستگیتون نباشین. و that's the planning that we do. یه مثالی که من میزنم، شما کسی بیگ بر رفته، سو سامت بیگ بر، نمیدونم از کدوم بر رفتی، ولی یه جایش هست که بهش میگن the rim of the world، فکر میکنم هایوی 18. خیلی جای قشنگه، من خیلی دوست دارم، یادتون گفتم من 15 سالگی اومدم، ولی پدر من خیلی شما رو دوست داشتن و هر ویکند میشد، هر موقع تدریبی ما میرفت شما. به طوری که من 15 سالگی اومدم هنوز جاده چالوش و اون قهوه‌خونه‌هاش رو من هنوز حفظم و اون پیچا و اینایی که داشت و این یه ذره من یاد جاده چالوش می‌ندازه. این خیابون ریمون دو ورلد وقتی شما ببین خیلی خوشمنظر است، ولی اگر نوازو کردین نرده داره. با وجودی که نرده داره شما هنوز یه ذره فرمون رو چسبیدین محکم و یه ممکنه هم یه یواشکی یه نگاهی بکنید، ولی حواستون جمع به خیابون، به جاده، درسته؟ حالا مجسم کنید که شما رفتید توی جاده، همون جاده 18 و این نرده ها وجود نداره. بهتون قول میدم که اینجوری گرفتی فرمانو چشون از خیابون برداشته نمیشه. حالا هرچی هم باشه من اینجوری هم با ترس و لرز یواش داریم میریم، برای اینکه ما گاردرل نداریم. چرا من این مثال رو دوست دارم؟ برای اینکه کاری که ما میکنیم، برنامه ریزی که ما برای خانوادگانی که با من کار میکنن و دوستانی که با من کار میکنن اینه که ما میان پورتفولیو شما رو میگیریم و براش گاردرل میذاریم که سعی کنیم از دره نریم. اشتباه میشه، مارکت عوض میشه، بازم شاید بالا پایین بریم، مثل که شاید خدا نکرده یه ذره به نرده بزنیم، به گاردرین بزنیم، ولی برمیگردیم جاده امنی. حالا ماشینمون یه ذره خراب شد، we can repair، میتونیم جلو بریم. ولی اگه گاردرین نداشته باشین از دره میتونیم بریم پایین. That's why I love this story. انشاءالله که مفید بودم. حالا راجع به ابزار چی صحبت کنیم؟ ببینید یک عالمه اینفورمیشن بد توی بازار اینوستینگ هست، توی فاینانشال پلنینگ هست. اولا که خیلی کانفیوزی شده برای دوستان، خانوادگانی که اول هستین، کسایی که میخوان اینوست کنین، برای اینکه اگه با یک اینشورنس ایجنت صحبت بکنین ایشون میشن فاینانشال ادوایزر، اگه با استاک بروکر صحبت کنین ایشون هستن فاینانشال ادوایزر، اگه با بانک صحبت کنین بانک فاینانشال ادوایزر داره، با مورگیج کمپانی صحبت کنین فاینانشال ادوایزر داره، همه شون هم فاینانشال ادوایزر. و باور کنین که ما نمیتونیم اکسپرت باشیم تو هر چیزی، باید بدونیم که تو چه چیزایی خوب هستیم و چه چیزایی بد هستیم. مثلا من براتون گفتم که من توی خرید و فروش استاک بله لایسنسشو دارم، میتونم استاک میتونم نگه بدارم، ولی ما نصیحت بهتون نمیکنیم که ببینید این الان استاک خیلی داغیه بعد بخریمش، بعد هم دو روز دیگه بفروشیمش. این کار استاک بروکر. برای همین خیلی information bad. There's a lot of myths and misconceptions. من میخوام نشون کنیم که you have good information. حالا در اینجا من خلاصه‌شو بهتون بگم. وقتی که ما باهاتون میشینیم این illustration رو پرسونالی براتون انجام میدیم. ما پول رو به سه دنیا تقسیم میتونیم بکنیم. یه دنیا از دنیای فیکس که بانک و دولت و اینشورنس کمپانی ها هستن. تو این دنیا ما پول نمیتونیم از دست بدیم. میخوان اگه بنویسیم اینجا میشه CD و savings account، اینجا میشه saving bonds، اینجا میشه fixed annuities. تو این دنیا اصل پول ما سیفه، ولی آیا میدونید پول دار بشیم اینجا؟ نه. چقدر پول دار داریم؟ 0.5%، 2%، خیلی مثلا شاهکار کنیم. برای همین خیلی ها مجبوریم که بیایم تو این دنیا، دنیای بهش میگیم مارکت ریت، بالاش بخواهم بینیسیم مارکت ریت. اینجاست که ستاکس هست، میوچوال فاند هست، باند فاند هست، ریل استیت هست، چیزهایی هست به نام وریبل انویتی، من زیاد دوست ندارم، ولی اینا همه اونجا هستن. حالا توی اون دنیای ستاک مارکت یا مارکت ریت، آیا ما میتونیم خیلی پول در بیاریم؟ چرا؟ 2007، 2013 خیلی میتونیم پول در بیاریم، ولی آیا میتونیم همه قدر پولمون رو
ببازیم؟
خلاصه از دست بدیم. برای همین چون یادتون نره میتونیم اینجا یه عراق بکشیم بالا، یه عراق بکشیم پایین. راستی من اینو چون پر نکردم کامپلاینس ما اجازه نمیده که، چون هر چی که من بذارم بعد فاین پرینت بذارم جا نبود، برای همین اینو من خلاصه براتون میگم، بعدا اگه خواستی میتونیم شخصی که نشستیم براتون همشو تعریف کنم با جوری که فاین پرینتش هست و all the disclosures. حالا در زمان 90s که گفتم مارکت خیلی خوب بود، این دنیا داشت خیلی پول روز میکرد به اون دنیا. بانک‌ها داشتن دیپازیت از دست میدادن، همه پولشون داشتن میبردن مارکت. اینشورنس کامپنی هم داشتن پولشون میبردن توی مارکت. They created a new world, I call it a linked rate world. Linked rate یعنی لینک داره، یه لینکه، یه میخواین یه ارا بکشین به اینجوری از اینجا به اینجا. منظور چیه؟ منظور اینه که تمام این سیفتی های این دنیا رو برداشتن لینک دادن به اون دنیا که درآمد اون تا یه حدی از اون دنیای مارکت بیاد. و اینجا چی هست؟ چیزهایی به نام اکولی لینک سیدیز. اینا یه سیدی هایی بودن که به جایی که قول به شما بدن چه درصدی بگیریم، با درصد قول بهتون نمیداد، ولی اگه مارکت میرفت بالا شما یه مقداری از اون مارکت میرفتیم بالا، ولی اگه مارکت میرفت پایین چون سیدی بود اصل پولتون فیکس بود و اون چیزی که گین کردید داشتید. Government came out with TIPS, T-I-P-S, TIPS. If you want to write it down, it's Treasury Inflation Protected Securities. Just write TIPS, I can explain it to you later. These were bonds that were associated with the CPI. So if the bond was paying 3 or 4% and CPI was 2%, you could see 7 or 8%. Today we don't see that much of TIPS because we can't find bonds that are paying 4 or 5%. And inflation, according to our government, we don't have much inflation, so we don't see much of that. What we see a lot of are linked annuities. You might have heard of them, or sometimes referred to as fixed index annuities. Very popular, because they took the fixed annuity, they said, what if we tie the gain to something of an index of the market like the S&P 500. But the catch is, everything has a catch. The catch is, you don't get a lot of the upside. You have limited growth. Very popular. But for baby boomers, today, they have actually attached an income guarantee. 4%, 6%. All these guarantees are backed by the safety and claims paying ability of the insurance company. So we want to make sure we're choosing the right insurance company, but it's a great way of providing a safe income for you. So this world has the protection of this world and the potential growth of this world. Basically the both of the world. اوکی، بعد من 10 دقیقه وقت بدید.
میشه برش کنم که غذا رو بزنم
بیرون؟ نه، 10 دقیقه رو وقت بدید. مرسی. قول میدم 10 دقیقه تمام. سنگی.
از این مدتی من بگید.
دراز بشتر بدید. حالا اونا رو بعد هم بگم. چون میخواد شام بیارن. 10 more minutes. این، شما کسی این گراف رو دیده؟ این گراف یه اگزمپل از این فنیه که خط قرمز ستاک مارکته، خط سبز شما میبینید بالا، ولی ببینید وقتی مارکت کرش میکنه پایین نمیریم، مارکت میره بالا شما میرید بالا. ولی ببینید چه این خط تیزه اینجا. We're not growing as much. That's the catch. That's the fine print.
Okay? Let's ask you guys one time here. Let the show me this.
In terms of UK, we're looking for fixed and fixed index annuities but they can give you a regular monthly income. They can ensure you don't run out of money. That will give you a comfortable retirement. It reduces your tax liability. But it protects you against market volatility, which is the main reason we like this for income management. There's another thing that I'll hit on very quick. Right now, it's very popular because of the timing. They're called REITs, Real Estate Investment Trust. These are limited partnerships that are non-correlated to the stock market. So no matter what happens to the stock market, because it's real estate, has nothing to do with it, you get interest. The interest are not guaranteed. You do have risk because they're not like an annuity, it's like an insurance company. So we gotta be aware of making sure what you're getting into. But generally right now they're paying 6 to 8% every month. So it can be a basket separate from everything else. We can sprinkle some REITs in your portfolio. For those of you who are in the stock market, whether you have an IRA, 401k, the biggest message I get from people is that, oh, I'm very conservative. Oh, I don't like risk in the stock market. Then I say, okay, let me stress test your portfolio. After we do that, we do this analysis for them, we see that, oh my God, this guy that said he's pretty conservative, the portfolio came out moderate. Example here is this client had 1.5 million. In a 2008 year, they could lose almost 40%, $600,000. In a good year, they could be up 60%. But most of our clients, when they come to see me, they said, David, I don't want to see these reds. I don't want to see these reds. Can I redesign my portfolio to be more in the middle? I'm okay with 6%, 7%. And I'm okay if I lose a little bit, but I don't want to see 40% downturn. How do we learn about that? Is after we stress test your portfolio, which we can do that as a service to you. This is another good one. If the market is down 30%, and if the market is up 30%, am I even?
No.
No. Many people think so. You have to be up 50% to be even. So we saw this happen in 2008. When is the next time we're going to see a 50% return in the market? How much risk should I take? How much of my money should be in the market? We have a rule of 100. You take your age of 100, you deduct your age, that might be, it's not rocket science, this is not a gospel thing, but that might be your comfort level of how much money you want to have in the stock market. So if you're 65, 35% might be okay. Some people want more, some people want less. This is a guide. Legal concern. I'm gonna go through this real quick because the dinner is ready.
No, okay.
So here's a big issue. If you live in the state of California, if you have nothing except one piece of property, and if you have people who you love, make sure you see an attorney. Make sure you have a trust, a living trust. Here's why. Probate is a very, very difficult and expensive thing in California. We're in one of the most difficult and the most expensive states in the country. So you've got to have a living trust. You've got to have a will. When you go see an attorney that specializes in estate planning, they know what to do. If you don't know of an attorney, please see me. We know attorneys here and in Orange County that we can recommend to you that specialize in that area. Here's why I talk about this. Many people think, oh, my kids don't have to pay any taxes because I have a trust. That's not true. Trust avoid probate. Trust do not avoid taxes. Somebody has to pay the taxes. So if you didn't pay it, guess who's going to pay it later? The children and grandchildren. You might say, I don't care. If you don't care, I don't care. But if you do, you need to plan for it now. Okay? Another very important issue, beneficiary designation. We see the biggest mistakes here. You have these accounts everywhere. Maybe 30 years ago you had a 401k, now you're no longer with that company, you left it alone. So I had a client, they came to visit me, we were reviewing everything. They said, I said, do you know who's the beneficiary of this account? Oh yeah, I just went and saw my attorney, we just updated everything, everything is in good shape. I said, do you know who's the beneficiary of this account? Well, I'm sure it's my wife. Let's call the company. We called the company, guess who was the beneficiary of his account? His ex-wife. I'm going to show my attorney. I need all the changes. It doesn't matter.
It's okay.
It's not okay. It's not okay. Whoever name is on there, they're going to get the money. No matter what your will says, no matter what your trust says. So, as I'm speaking, if you're thinking on my accounts, then oh my gosh. Who's the beneficiary? We don't put so-and-so, whatever. Please make sure you come and see us. We can help you with that. Always list a secondary beneficiary, a contingent beneficiary. Because when you put a primary beneficiary, it avoids probate. But if you don't put a secondary beneficiary, then it goes to probate. Make sure you always have a name. If you think you're not sure, put a name. You can always change it later. It's better for you to put a name rather than the government deciding, right? So, common mistakes that we see, hold on a sec, not protecting yourself from market losses when it comes to retirement. Relying on unreliable investments to cover your income, expenses. No estate plan. I don't have a will, I don't have a trust, I don't need it, I'm good, I don't have much money. If you have one piece of property, you want to have that. And finally, the beneficiary designation. So, if I'm getting paid caught, for this sheet, I got Moyer Boshi, Houston Anadi. من هفته یک بار تو لس‌آنجلس هستم و آدرس آفیسمون هم بهتون میدیم یا سکن آفیسی که گفتم This is for me to prepare for our meeting. So, for example, if you listen to my radio show, I always say you have to have at least assets of 200,000 or more that I can do planning. I cannot do planning if we have less than 200,000. It's not because I'm too good and I can't accept a $50,000 account. من میشینم با تو صحبت بکنم، چایی بخوریم، کافی بخوریم، هر سوالی دارید براتون جواب میدم. But just be aware of it. I cannot help you if you don't have a portfolio of at least 200,000 or more. و اینجوری من میدونم که چجوری براتون برنامه‌ریزی کنم. برای همین اگر مایل بودید اینو مارک کنید، ما قبل از اینکه شما بیارن و قضا رو روی اینا ریخته بشه، ایشون میان اینا رو پیکاپ میکنن، یه قرار با شما میذارن، بعد بهتون یه کانفرمیشن شیت میدید، کاری که میکنید میشینید، we do a personal strategy. ممکنه نیم ساعت طول بکشه، ممکنه یک ساعت طول بکشه، هر سوالی که دارین جواب میدم، بعدم که کارم تموم شد، هیچ obligation نیست، we can be done، ولی اگه خواستین ادامه بدیم، اگه فهمیدید که we're the right fit for each other، we love to help you. خب، دوستان عزیز چیزی یاد گرفتیم؟ شام میشه جان؟ من هم میام میشه دوست دارم فرزاده جان برو بریم تایید
بله